We will solve some of the engineering mechanics problems. Take the first one. In it, AB is the bar, it is given. A is the hinged support here. And BC is the cable. This is the cable. This bar is making 60 with the vertical. This cable is making 30 degrees with this bar. And S is the tensile force in a cable. S is the tensile force in this cable. So at Q point, at middle of the bar, bar length is L, it is also given. At AD means at this D point, Q force is acting, it is 2 turns. AD length is half of the bar, L by 2, it is also given. Here what we have to find in it? We have to find the tension in this string because of application of this load. Okay, this load is acting in downward direction. Because of that, how much tension is coming in this cable? And also we have to find RA value, reactions at hinged support. Okay, for solving these two, S and RA value, we need to do FBD diagram, free body diagram. So in free body diagram, we are removing all the supports. We are taking the reactions because of these supports. Okay, let us do the FBD diagram. Here, do the free body diagram of this given diagram. Free body diagram means it is freed from the surfaces and taking the reactions at these points. Okay. Now here I am removing this vertical wall here. I am taking AB bar here like this. This is L by 2. This is also L by 2. Okay. A point, this bar is making 60 degrees here. Okay. And the Q is also making 60 because for the same bar, with vertical, it is also making 60 degrees. And at B point, this cable has some tension. Yes, it is. I am taking the tension along this bar or cable. It is making 30 degrees. It is also given. Now here, we have to take the components. Two components we have to take. One is parallel to this inclined line, inclined bar. And the other component is vertical to this bar. There are two components we have to take. And here A is a hinged point. It is a hinged support. At hinged support, always two forces are acting. One is along the surface. One is perpendicular to the surface. If we are we don't know the direction. Okay, at A point, just I am assuming one is... Here I am taking RA or RA1 reaction at A1 perpendicular. One is horizontal, RA2. Okay. One hinged point means there are two forces acting. One is perpendicular to the surface, one is along the surface. Okay. The resultant V is acting at some point like this, RA. We don't know in which directions these are acting. Just we had to assume initially RA2 is acting along this line, along this AB bar. One is perpendicular. The resultant is RA. We had to find this RA here. And also we had to find this angle also, direction of RA. How much angle it is making with the bar. This phi angle also we had to find. After that, Q. Q is vertical. Vertically downward. It is 2 turns. Here also there are two components. One is along the horizontal surface. So according to the downward direction, we can assume this is coming like this. And one is perpendicular to this surface. Okay. In previous examples, in previous videos, for horizontal component and vertical component, we are taking for the horizontal beam. But the beam here making some angle. That's why we are taking some components are along this line, along this beam. Some are perpendicular to this beam. Okay. So what is the horizontal component for this? If you are making right angle triangle, this value will give cos. Q cos 60. Or instead of Q, we can write 2 cos 60. This vertical component is 2 sin 60. Okay. And here S is making 30. Here also components are, one is perpendicular, one is along the surface. What is this component along the surface? S cos 30 What is the vertical component? S sine 30. S sine 30. Like this. Just whatever diagram given, we are taking the components, two components at each point. One component is along the surface. One is perpendicular to the surface. Okay. For perpendicular surface, I am taking sine. Along the surface, I am taking cos. Why means, if we are taking right angle triangle like this, let us assume this one, S is acting like this. Okay. Here, this is the S value resultant. I am taking this is horizontal component, this is vertical component. This angle is 30 degrees. This will give, after marking all the components, we have to follow three conditions for finding the unknown values. What are the three conditions? In previous cases, we are taking sigma FH is 0. Whatever horizontal component should be 0. Vertical component should be 0. And sigma M should be 0. Okay. But here, we are not taking horizontal component. We are taking the along the surface. Okay. Those components we are taking along the surface should be 0. Perpendicular to the surface, perpendicular forces should be 0. There should be no unbalanced perpendicular forces. Okay. And then moment about any point. I am taking A point. Moment about A point should be 0. At that time only this beam is in equilibrium. It should not move up and down like that. So first take the sigma F along the surface. Forces should be 0. First condition. Sigma F along the surface should be 0. What is the first force here along the surface? Ra2. I am taking this direction, along the direction positive. We can assume any direction here. Okay, positive. By seeing the final minus or plus, we can decide. I am assuming this is positive and this direction is negative. This direction I am considering positive. This direction I am considering negative. Now sigma F along the surface forces should be 0. Now here I am taking Ra2. Ra2 is acting in this direction positive. Now Ra2. Next the force is 2 cos 60. It is also positive. Next force, it is S cos 30. It is upward. So minus S cos 30 is equal to 0. So here there are two unknown values, Ra2 and S. Keep as it is these two. Ra2 minus S cos 30 is equal to minus 2 cos 60. Okay. So here there are two unknown values. Keep as it is. I am taking this is the equation 1. Okay. What is the next condition? Sigma vertical forces or perpendicular forces to the surface should be 0. Now write down here. Here I am writing sigma F perpendicular forces should be 0. Now what is the first perpendicular force? I am taking this direction forces positive. Okay. This direction forces negative. Okay. Now these are negative. So at Ra1 upward like this, so I am taking positive. Ra1 here I am writing Ra1. Next force is 2 sine 60, it is downward negative, minus 2 sine 60, and then upward force positive plus S sine 30 is equal to 0. Here also Ra1 and S are the unknown values, so write down Ra1 plus S sine 30 is equal to 2 sine 60. So minus will go. So this is the equation 2. For unknown values, we have to give the number for the equation so that it is easy for calculating the unknown values at the end. Now what is the next condition? Sigma MA should be 0. Okay. For sigma MA 0, I am writing here. Take the third condition, sigma ma is 0, moment about the a point should be 0. So I am taking for clockwise, I am taking positive, for anticlockwise, I am taking negative. Now about the a point we are taking. So perpendicular force for this is 2 sin 60, because of this only moment will come. Along the surface forces, moment will not come. So 2 sin 60 into this distance, it is half of the length L by 2. 2 sin 60 into L by 2, it is clockwise. Positive. For clockwise, take here 2 sin 60 into this distance, half of the length L by 2, it is clockwise positive. So 2 sin 60 into L by 2 minus, why we are considering minus for next force means, S sin 30 next force, so it is anticlockwise. S sin 30 into total length is L, so it is anticlockwise, that's why I kept here minus S sin 30 into L is equal to 0, because there are no other forces. Because of it, moment for the beam is coming. Now here, from this calculate, one unknown S value here. So I am taking S sin 30 into L is equal to, I am sending this term here, 2 sin 60 into L by 2. Okay, 2 will be cancelled and L will be cancelled. S is equal to sin 60 by sin 30. Okay, what is sin 60 value? Root 3 by 2. Sin 30 means 1 by 2. So 2 will go up. 2 will be cancelled. So S is equal to root 3. What are the units for this? Here the units are given in terms of tons. So here also S is equal to root 3 tons. Keep in one box the tension in the string. Yes, we had to find S is equal to, we got the value root 3 tons. Okay, now next is we had to find RA value. So for RA, how many components? RA2 component, RA1 component. We had to find RA2 by using this equation. We had to substitute this S value by using this equation root 3. So keep root 3 in it, by using calci we will get RA2. Similarly, if you are keeping S here, unknown value root 3 it is, we will get RA1. So find out RA1 and RA2 by using the calci. Let us do. After substituting S value in these two equations, we will get RA2 is 1 by 2, RA1 is root 3 by 2. Now at A point, these two components are acting. One is along the surface, one is perpendicular to the surface. Let us do here. So I took A point here. So RA1 we are taking perpendicular to the surface, RA1. How much RA1 we got? It is root 3 by 2. And next force is perpendicular to this RA2. How much RA2 we got? 1 by 2. Resultant will give the third side of the triangle according to the triangular law. So resultant is equal to root of RA1 square plus RA2 square. Now substitute these values in it, we will get R is equal to 1 ton by using the calci. Okay, so this is the answer we had to find, how much RA is acting at the hinged point, means 1 ton is acting. In which direction it is acting? So for finding this value, phi value, direction of RA, so here I am writing phi is equal to, or we can write tan phi is equal to, because we know parallel component and perpendicular component. Perpendicular component by parallel component, phi is equal to tan inverse of what is RA1 value, root 3 by 2. What is RA2 value? 1 by 2. So 2 will be cancelled. Tan inverse of root 3. Okay, the value will be, how much value it is? Tan inverse of root 3 means it is a 60 degrees. So resultant is making 60 degrees with this line. Here if we are taking, this is a RA, this is a 60 degrees. Okay, now these are our answers. RA value 1 ton and this is the angle. This is the entire procedure of this given diagram.